Hi, it's Jillian from Loveleigh Loops, and in this video I'm going to show you how to easily create this metallic look effect on your lettering. If you stay till the end, I'll show you a bonus tip on how to change the color of your letters really quickly and make it look like a colorful metallic style. So to start off, let's go to our gallery and create a new canvas. You can use whatever size your project is. I like to change my background color to black first so that we can see this effect come to life. So open up your layer menu. And on the bottom, you see background color. Tap on that. To get a pure black, you can double tap in the bottom left of this circle. We're actually going to be using the classic menu for this. So that's the one that looks like a square down here. And you can just drag this node to the bottom left if you want pure black. You can also make it like a very dark gray. That still looks really nice with this effect. Okay, and then I'm going to choose done. Now it's time to create the letters. I'm using the streak brush that's inside the calligraphy set, and my brush size is around 12%. So for this, I'm going to choose a gray from my color palette. So to open your colors, tap on the circle up here in the right, and let's go to the classic menu. Over here on the left hand side, if we drag this up and down, we're just going to get different amounts of black or white or any gray in between. So we want to start off with like a medium gray, somewhere in the middle right here. And for this step, we're going to just create your lettering with this color. I'm just going to keep it simple and just write metallic. So we're making like a silver effect right now. Once your letters are written, we need to add some color to them only in certain spots. So a quick and basic way of doing this is using Alpha Lock. To turn Alpha Lock on using your layers, open your layer menu and you'll see layer one here. You can tap on the layer and choose Alpha Lock from the pop-out menu, and now you'll see in this thumbnail of your layers that it has like a checkerboard behind it. And this means that if I just pick a random color and I try drawing on my canvas, it doesn't work unless I'm drawing on top of where the letters already exist. I'm going to undo that by using two fingers and tapping on the screen. All right, so to start getting this metallic effect, we need to choose a color that's lighter than the gray you were using. So make sure you have the gray that you were using selected. And inside of this classic menu, we want to increase this closer to white. So you can drag that node, or in these three sliders here, you can take the bottom one and drag it to the right. And we want this to be about halfway between where it was and where white is. Okay, so we're just going to drag this up. Then we need to choose a brush. Go to your brush library and find the airbrushing set. Inside of this set, there are several different types of airbrushes. We're going to use the one called soft brush. Once you have that chosen with your light gray, we can increase the size of our brush to about 10%. This may vary based on the size of your project. And we're going to focus a stripe of this lighter gray going sort of diagonal down the middle of our letters. So you can just lightly, if you press really hard, it's going to give you a more opaque color. Whoops, I just grabbed my eraser. There we go. Okay, so we're just sort of concentrating in the middle of our letters. Try not to get any on the end or the beginning of your word. Then we're going to increase this lightness even more by dragging this node up closer to white. It's not white yet, but you can see it's getting pretty close. I'm going to decrease the brush size here too, down to about 6%, because I just want a smaller section of this really light color. So I'm just gonna go right down the middle, sort of diagonal stripe. And then you can add like a tiny bit on just like a couple of ends of the letters too. This can kind of add a neat effect. So just at the very beginning of my M, at the very end of my C, maybe the dot of my I, and part of this T crossbar. So this will be different based on whatever word you're writing. Just a couple of extra splotches of color. Okay, so this is already giving us a great effect. And if you want, you can continue adding even just like a little bit more of pure white, just a very tiny amount just in the center or in a few small areas. I would just do a couple with pure white. Okay, and so now you can see we have our metallic effect. So if you want to change the color to something other than silver, you can open up your layers and pick a color. I'm just going to choose this sort of medium pink. And we're going to take this and drag it into our layer right here, and it should turn this color. So if for some reason for you it looks like this, where it's only changing part of it to pink, that means your color drop threshold isn't high enough. So I'm going to undo that. Take my color in here, and now before I lift my pen off the screen, I'm going to drag my pencil to the right, and you can see in the top menu, color drop threshold is increasing. So I want it to increase high enough so that the color is changing to pink. So I may need to redo that a couple times just to make sure that this is actually working. Okay, so once you increase it all the way, lift your pen, and now we have a pink metallic effect. You can also go to your adjustments and find hue, saturation, brightness, and then the slider at the bottom called hue, you can drag it to the left and the right to change the color. You can change the saturation or like how vibrant it is, and then the brightness is gonna make it closer to black or white. So this looks kind of like a bronze effect now. And then just tap the wand to commit that change. I hope you enjoyed learning how to make a really quick and easy metallic effect to your letters. If you try it, you can tag us on social media at Loveleigh Loops, and make sure you subscribe to our channel for more great videos like this one. Thanks so much for watching. Have a lovely day.